Welcome back, everyone. Today we're talking about timing, and we're dealing with the Piaggio Citta. It's a Vespa engine. This has the Kinetic CDI with a Parmakit box. A lot of people say the Kinetic CDI does not work with the stock Woodruff key position. So I'm going to check the timing, and then I might modify the timing. Please like and subscribe, buy me a coffee if you can, and check out CornPed.com for some stickers or merchandise. Some people say you can set the timing with the engine in the subframe. I'm going to take it out. It'll be a lot easier. Before you pull the engine, make sure you know which way it rotates. In this case, the engine spins clockwise. First thing I'll do is pull the variator. You can drop the carburetor rail at the bottom, like that. Now I need to take off the engine bolts. I don't want to lose these. I'm going to put them back together. All right, this part is fun. You kind of have to tilt the engine a little to get it out. Pull the rest of the motor bolts. And get these wires out. There we go. Jeez. We can take the cover off. Okay, so I have the CDI box wired up, it's in the back, and then I have this little spark indicator that I connected to the spark plug boot. I can put a link where you can get these, they're really handy. And so right now, it's totally stock, and if I spin it, it should spark. The first thing that I like to do is find top dead center. You can use a micrometer, or you can use a little device like this. I got it from Treatland. Right there. As I rotate this around, it goes right to there. Right there is top dead center. Okay, so we know where top dead center is. Let's just make a little mark. Let's call it right here. Okay. So that's where, whoop, that's top dead center. All right, now we can check the timing. Let's check it. And it's not there. It's not there. Oh, it's way over here. So it's firing right here. It's way after top dead center. Okay, I'm gonna make a mark where it was firing. Okay, so that's where it actually fires. Now, this is what's tricky. This is what's tricky about CDIs. And this is where people's brains get a little confused. This is always gonna fire when the flywheel is right here, okay? And so what we have to do is now rotate the crank so that the piston is 1.8 millimeters before top dead center, and then have the flywheel be in this location. Because right now, when the piston is 1.8 millimeters before top dead center, the flywheel is in this position on the crank. And so we actually want it over here. I'm gonna pop off the flywheel. Just like that. Here's the Woodruff key. We do not need that. I'm gonna lap this really, really quick. This will just help it seat a little bit better. Okay. All right. Okay, let's find top dead center again. So it's right there. There's top dead center. I'm gonna go back 1.8 millimeters. There's one, there's 0.8. That's top dead center. And if we rotate it counterclockwise, that's 1 millimeter, that's 2 millimeters. So we go just a little like that, that's about 1.8. Just remember, I want it right there. I'll put this thing on, and that's a magnetic spot where it wants to spin. So I'm just gonna put it right here where there's no load on it. Now the easiest way to tighten this is with the variator. So I'm gonna hold this thing. I'm gonna try to tighten this. Okay. So now top dead center is right about here. And if we rotate it to this mark, the piston should be 1.8 millimeters before top dead center. Okay, so it's right about there. So we can check this timing now. All right, let's check this. Ooh, that is perfect. And you can see how the timing curves. The timing actually advances as I spin it up. And if I could spin it fast enough with this drill, it would retard. Ooh. All right, that looks pretty good. Got the timing set. It's good to go. I can pull this off. I can pull the variator part off, put it in the motor, and put it back together knowing that the timing is set and it's good. Let's put this engine back in the subframe. I do want to put my spark plug through, my spark plug cable through first, because otherwise I don't think I can. Okay. I also want to tuck my wires up. Just like that. There we go. It's pretty easy once you get the hang of it. All right, don't forget there is a space around the back here. This moves the engine back and forth. Then now we can put on the variator. Just like that. Okay, and put the belt on. Make sure the boss is in the ramp plate. There's a little lip for that. And I like to use a little driver to put it on. This is an old one, so it's not actually that strong, but it's perfect for these. Oh, and I forgot the fan cover. So I'll take it out and I'll put the fan cover back on. But for the purposes of this video, I think we're good. Let me know if this timing video helped you. Let me know any questions you have. Have a great day and stay tuned.